Hello and welcome to the Fixit Shed. If you like to save money by doing things yourself, you're going to want to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss anything. So this week I have a puzzle to solve. A few days ago I got my electric bill and I was shocked. In the bill I had used about 3 times the amount of kilowatt hours as I normally do. So I need to find out why. So I had used 1,387 kilowatt hours over the course of the month, which if you figure that out, it's about 46 kilowatts per day, or 2 kilowatts per hour. So my normal usage is about 16 kilowatts per day, which is about 1 kilowatt every 2 hours, or half kilowatt every hour. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to check and make sure that I'm still using that much electricity. So I'm going to go out and I'm going to take a reading, and then I'm going to check it again in a half an hour and see if it has increased, and if it has, then I will check it again in another 30 minutes and make sure that it's still consuming at that same rate. Okay, so I went and I checked the meter, and 30 minutes later it had increased by 1 kilowatt hour, and so I waited another 30 minutes, checked again, and it had gone up again by another kilowatt hour, so it's using 2 kilowatts an hour still. Alright, as you can see from the meter, it's a digital meter, so it doesn't have that spinning wheel so that you can kind of see how quickly you're using electricity, but it does have these little blocks that appear, and they will kind of give you an indication of how fast the electricity is being used. Alright, so the reason I'm in the basement is because I'm going to flip some breakers and turn things off and see if we can figure out what is using up this much electricity. So first of all, a quick explanation about why I have these 3 electrical boxes. This is the main panel where electricity comes in from the grid, and then it jumps over to this box, which is just a switch, really. It's just a big switch. And then you have this panel here, which contains a lot of critical things like my water pump, the refrigerator, a few outlets and lights. And the reason that it's split up this way, like this black wire here goes to a plug that's outside that I can plug into a generator, right? So if I flip this switch, you know, it'll go from using the grid electricity to using the generator electricity, and so the generator will power just what's in this panel. Like I said, the critical items like my water, you know, so that you have water and so that you have, you know, the refrigerator can stay cold, just the few basic things. All right, so I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna start turning some breakers off. I do have my wife outside, she's looking at the meter, and we're gonna see if we can tell when I turn something off if it slows down the meter. All right, so I'm gonna start off the breakers that have the bars on, because those are the large consumers of electricity. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to turn off the oven. Did the meter change?
No.
Alright, I'm going to turn off the hot water heater. Anything?
No.
I'm going to turn off the dryer. Anything?
No.
No. The air conditioning, that shouldn't be on.
Correct. Okay. Not doing anything.
Alright, so how about the water pump?
Yes, that's what it does.
Okay. Thank you. So it ended up being that the switch went bad and the pump was running 24 hours a day for a month. And I'm not sure if this was related or not, but the pump was not putting out as much pressure as it should. You know, did something happen to it because it was on for a month straight? We're not sure. But also we've had problems with the pressure tank. It has lost pressures and we've had to, you know, repressurize it. So that has a slow leak. We decided we're just going to replace everything. We replaced the pump, we replaced the pressure tank, we replaced the switch, we replaced the pressure gauge. So pretty much that system has been limping along since we moved in 2 years ago, and we just felt it was time to replace it. So now the pressure is good, the pump shuts off when it should and turns on when it should, so now we just want to see what our December electric bill looks like. Alright, so the December electric bill came and we used 462 kilowatt hours for the month, which is back down into a normal range, as you can see in the graph. Alright, so that wraps up the mystery of the shocking electric bill. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Take care.